Hello everyone, I'm Tomoya Suzuki from Kyokushia. It's my pleasure to introduce our recent results for Random Reads. We achieved DRAM-like performance with low latency flash memory. We focus on applications that have a lot of random read accesses beyond the DRAM capacity. Key value store or graph analytics are examples of such applications. In this talk,We assume they require 50 to 100 million IOPS per server node. SSD is one of the solutions to deal with data that exceeds the DRAM capacity. But random read performance of the high-performance SSD is 1 or 2 million IOPS per drive. Even if tens of such SSDs are attached in single server, it is not enough for our target applications.Recently, low latency flash memory devices are emerging. For example, Kioxia developed a low latency flash named XL Flash. Its read latency is less than 5 microseconds, which is an order of magnitude better than standard flash memory. Random read IOPS is also an order of magnitude better. In this talk, we use a prototype board using the low latency flash.This board delivers up to 11 million IOPS for random reads. By attaching 10 boards in single server, we can achieve over 100 million IOPS in total. So, the device capability is enough for our targets. But there is another concern. That is, the more IOPS, the more CPU time is consumed for IO requests.It is important to reduce the CPU overhead for IOs. In conventional IO access, read requests are handled by kernel, which consumes microsecond level CPU time per read access. To avoid the kernel overhead, direct access from user space can be used. The CPU overhead per access is reduced to 100 nanoseconds.But it is not enough for our use case. For example, let's suppose we perform random reads of 100 million IOPS on 20 cores. In this case, each read is performed every 200 nanoseconds, and 50% of CPU time is consumed for IOs. We propose two techniques to minimize the CPU overhead. First,We modify the NVMe protocol. Second, we utilize the stackless coroutines for fast context switches. By using the proposed access method, we can reduce the CPU time per access to less than 10 nanoseconds. This may be less than the latency to access DRAM.We modify the existing NVMe protocol.To reduce CPU overhead. These are data flow diagrams of NVMe protocol and proposed one. We eliminate accesses to PCIe space from CPU. Also, we increase spatial locality to reduce accesses to DRAM. We also utilize lightweight context switch with stackless coroutine.XL Flash has microsecond level read latencies. After issuing read request, just waiting for the read response is a big waste of CPU time. So, after issuing a read request, a context switch to another context is performed. After enough time passed, the execution returns to the initial context and receives a response.To minimize the context switching time, we implement these contexts as stackless coroutine. As a result, the switching time among contexts is extremely short, and the total CPU overhead is 10 nanoseconds or less. It includes issuing a request, switching contexts, and acquiring the response. We have applied the proposed access method to large-scale graph processing.We put graph edge data on XL Flash. Some major graph algorithms need random reads for the edge data. but Excel Flash provides enough IOPS. In addition, the proposed access method keeps the CPU overhead equal to or less than DRAM access. For the evaluation, we use GAP benchmark. It is a set of graph algorithms optimized for DRAM. GAP is implemented by using OpenMP to parallelize a loop with multiple threads. We change the loop to parallelize not only by multi-threading, but also by hundreds or thousands of coroutines. Here is an experimental setup. We evaluated three graph algorithms, BFS, BC, and SSSP, which involve a lot of random reads to graph data. We will show the results of synthetic graphs, uniform random, and Kronecker graph in this talk. We use Xeon 16 cores and 9 XL flash boards connected by PCIe. The peak performance of 9 boards is 99 million IOPS in total. These are runtime comparisons using Excel Flash and DRAM. DRAM means that all graph data is placed on DRAM, and Excel Flash means that edge data are placed on Excel Flash. From this figure, we can see two observations. First, with Excel Flash, the execution time is about the same as DRAM. Some of them are even faster than DRAM. This is because the proposed access method is as fast as or faster than DRAM access in terms of CPU overhead. The second observation is that Excel Flash can also handle graphs exceeding DRAM capacity, and the execution time scales as expected. The blue line shows the actually measured IOPS, and the red line is an estimate of how much IOPS is required from the execution result when all data are placed on DRAM. BFS on uniform random graph requires about 30 million IOPS throughout the execution. Excel Flash provides sufficient IOPS, and it is faster than DRAM all the time. On the other hand, BFS on Kronecker graph requires around 200 million IOPS at the end of execution, while Excel Flash peaks at 17 million IOPS. This is partly slower than DRAM due to lack of IOPS, but overall execution is slightly faster than DRAM in this case. Here is a summary. Low latency flash enables 11 million IOPS random reads per drive and 100 million IOPS per node. We have reduced the CPU overhead for random read access to less than 10 nanoseconds. We have shown an application example of a DRAM-like execution time. We expected it to be useful for other read-intensive tasks with massive parallelism. Thank you for your attention.